we will start with the definition of the heat and internal energy. First, for the internal energy is all the energy of the system that is associated with its microscopic component. The microscopic component that is the atoms and molecules. When we form a reference frame at rest with respect to the center of mass of the system. So, this means that the internal energy in our modern view now is a form of mechanical energy, but it is a mechanical energy of the microscopic component of the system. So, in the point of view of the microscopic point of view, this is another kind of energy. In the past, when the scientist does not notice the existence of atom and molecule, they think that this is a very different kind of the energy other than the mechanical work that we have discussed. But for nowadays, we know that it is the same. And this concept is used in the kinetic theory of gas, that is the topic of the next chapter. Anyway, in the point of view of thermodynamics, we will call this internal energy. It is a macroscopic quantity. But if we look in the very detail of this energy, it is the microscopic component, the energy of the microscopic component of the system. And this energy is measured in the frame that is at rest with respect to the center of mass of the system. Here, it means that we are not interested in the bulk mechanical energy. So it means that our system is at rest respect to us, so there is no bulk kinetic energy or no bulk potential energy. If we set the potential energy equal to zero at the position of our system. So that is the definition of the internal energy. And next, heat. Heat is defined as the transfer of energy across the boundary of a system due to a temperature difference. The temperature difference between the system and its surrounding. So it means that you can transfer the energy to the system. If you do work, you do the mechanical energy transfer. But in the thermal process, that if there is no work, you can still transfer the energy to the system in terms of heat. And to do that, you need the temperature difference. If there is temperature difference, for example, if the surrounding is at the higher temperature, heat go into the system. But if the surrounding is at the lower temperature, heat go out of the system. And that is the definition of the heat. Be careful. Heat is not the energy, but is the energy transfer. When we talk about the energy in the thermal process, it's always be the internal energy. The heat is the energy transfer. Like when we do work, work is the energy transfer. Work itself is not energy, but it's the energy transfer. The kinetic and the potential energy is the energy. as a physical quantity, heat needs a unit. In the early study, the scientists think that heat is a kind of fluid, and they call this fluid the calorie. So, in the past, the scientists used the unit of heat as a calorie. And we use in short as a calorie. The name comes from the name of the fluid, calorie. Okay, and by definition, a calorie of heat is defined as the amount of the energy transfer necessary to rise the temperature of 1 gram of water from 14.5 degrees Celsius to 15.5 degrees Celsius. Rise the temperature of water from 14.5 to 15.5 degrees Celsius. The water, the 1 gram. 1 gram of water from 14.5 to 15.5 degrees Celsius, and we call this 1 calorie. If we write here, when we talk about calorie, here we use the lower letter or the lower letter, and the definition of the a calorie is follow this statement. But if we write down the word calorie in the capital letter, it means this is the kilo calorie. It is a kilo calorie. So if you have the big C here, it means that it's 1,000 of 1 calorie. Again, in the past, when the scientists expect that the heat is a kind of fluid, so the calorie is the amount of this fluid that flow from one object to the other object, and the flow of this fluid, the result of the flow of this fluid is that it changed the temperature. Okay. However, for now, we know that heat is one form of energy transfer, like work. So we use the same unit of the energy for the work. It means that we should or we must use the same unit for the heat also. So for the modern language, for the modern unit in the scientific community, we say that heat is the energy transfer so its unit have to be joule. The same unit as the work and the energy. anyway, in many subjects, we still use the word calorie for the heat. For example, if you want to diet to reduce your weight, and many people may say that you have to burn some kilocalorie of your energy to reduce your weight. So that is, we still use the word calorie in some subject. Also, when you talk about the air condition, you can see that we still use the different unit for the heat. That is, it is a British thermal unit. BTU. 1 BTU is equal to the amount of heat that required to rise the temperature of 1 pound of water from the temperature of 63 degrees Fahrenheit to 64 degrees Fahrenheit. Here we use a different temperature scale to define the British thermal unit, and we use this when you go and buy the air condition. But nowadays, scientists and engineers try to use the same unit, and the unit of joule is more and more popular now, and the unit of calorie, or maybe the British unit, may be fake in the future.